Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great Excel video for you today on what is a calculated item in a pivot table. Let's go ahead and dive in. I have Excel running. I have row one has my header row, also called fields. So I have seven fields going from dealership over to cost. In case you're wondering, in Excel, there's a pivot table, has two items. One is a calculated field. One is a calculated item. I'm focusing on the calculated item today. A calculated field, even though I'm not going to do it, would take the invoice amount in column F and subtract the cost in column G because those are two different fields. But notice in column E, I've got the word year. And I have intentionally 2 years, 2021 and 2022. Those are the only 2 years I have in there. But I want us to take 1 year, find out what's the difference from the previous year, and then figure out what is the percentage change. That's a calculated item compared to a calculated field. So let's go ahead and dive in right here. I usually put my pivot tables on a separate worksheet. But to keep this easy, I'm going to put it on the same worksheet. So here we go. Click inside your data, insert, pivot table. It picks up my entire range. Here's where I'm deviating from what I normally do, existing sheet. I'm going to put it right here in cell I3, I4, whatever it is. Hit OK. Scroll over to the right. There are the fields that were in row one running up and down. I'm going to take brand, I'm going to take year, Excel through year in the sum, just throw it under brand. And what do you want to sum up? I'm going to sum up the invoice amount. I'm going to just do a drag and drop. There we go, right here. So a couple other items I'm going to do just real quick before I get into this calculated item. Notice it's right below calculated field. These numbers are driving me crazy. Right click, number format, changing one changes them all. That works for me. There you go. I really don't care about the subtotals, but I'm going to leave them right now. But here we go. I got the year 2021 and 2022. Those are the only 2 years. But again, they came from the same field or the same column. So when we go to Pivot Table Analyze is the tab that I'm on. Fields, items, and sets, there is calculated field. That would be invoice amount minus cost, as an example, because there are two fields. If you notice, calculated item is not selected. This was intentional. You need to go click on one of the years. Now, when I go to calculated items, there is year, and look, there's the 2 years that I had. If I had 4 years, it would show me all 4 years right there, by the way. So now what do I want to do with these two fields? I'm making this up. I'm going to call it percentage difference. I'm abbreviating. It'll always say equals zero. I'm going to leave the equals. I'm going to get rid of the zero. So I need to subtract 2022 from 2021. That will be the dollar difference divided by the previous year, 2021. So I'm going to just do some double clicking. 2022 minus symbol 2021. Close, divided by, double click 2021. There I go. There's my formula. If you're worried about those extra spaces, just let them ride. That is fine. Click add. Click OK. Percentage difference. Now, because the year 2021 and 2022 are numbers, zero decimal places, I really want to see percentages, but if I make this a percentage, it's going to make everything a percentage. Or I could sit here and use the control key. If I only had two or three, I would. But look, if I scroll down here just to show you this, I've got quite a few in here. So here's my trick. Down here in the bottom right corner, there are your fields for your pivot table. Take year and drag it and put it above the brand. So now 2021 followed by 2022 followed by that percent difference. Highlight these. Home tab, I'm just going to make them a percentage. I could increase the decimal, but negative 63% works. Now swap them back in the bottom right. So now it's brand over year, and look, the percentage is held right there. So there you go. I hope this helps. In case you're ever wondering what in the world in Excel is a pivot item, it is one field that has multiple different data items, 2022, 2021. It could be text also. So I'm not going to do it here because I don't have it set up, but I could sum up if I had the United States in Canada, Spain, Italy, and Ireland. I could put some countries in Europe, classify them as Europe, and I could add the other ones and call them North America as an example. So you can do it with text and you can do it with numbers. Great tip. I'm going to give myself a thumbs up. Feel free to subscribe. Ring the bell. Let me know if you have any comments or questions about this. Have a great day. Thank you.